Welcome to a new tutorial on my channel. As you can see, I already prepared some circuits. And let's get right into it. So, the first circuit I have prepared is this one. This is for the extension of the piston extender. In this case, I used a 50 piston extender to demonstrate. This won't be a block-by-block tutorial, since everything is one wide. I will just explain the important things very quick. So here we have a dropper clock with 5 items in my case. To find out how many items you need, you will have to divide your amount of pistons plus the block you are pushing by 12. So in my case, I have 50 pistons and one block. Meaning I have to divide 51 by 12, and that is 4.25. And since it's bigger than 4, I will have to round up to 5. So if you, for example, got 8.39 or something, I don't know, you would have to round up to 9 items. Repeat on 3 ticks here. All of those are sticky pistons, as you can see on this side here. So I will show you how this works very quick. Set that to 5, activate it. So when you activate it once, you can see the block here gets pushed down. And so the comparator can't read an output. And this block here gets pushed down as well, so the items can flow from the hopper into the dropper. And if I activate it once again, you can see this block here gets pulled up, meaning the observer, meaning the comparator can now read an output, powering this block with which then powers this node block right here, and the observers pass the signal to this piston extender, which then pushes down the block again, so this can't read an output anymore. Then this block here but powers this dropper, which gets updated by the node block, and again the signal gets passed onto the sticky piston, which then spits out an observer beneath the block here, and that then powers the dropper, so all the items get shot back over to this hopper. And the last part then is this sticky piston with an observer, which then just powers this node block and gives a signal to power all the pistons. So if I do that normal speed now, you will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 signals are passed, and that then extends the piston extender from the back to the front. Okay, so the amount of pistons and observers you will have to you need is simple, easy to find out. So if you have, let's say, 4 pistons, you need to multiply the amount of pistons by 2 and then just subtract 1. So in my case, it's 4 times 2 is 8 and minus 1 is 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just a block here, and then if I just power that, you can see every piston gets powered. So the next circuit I have here is for the retraction. As you can see, when it's extended, it will look like this. Your last observer, that one here, would be right here, so you can see where you would have to put the observers going until the end, until the very last piston. As you can see here, droppers being butt powered by these observers, again diagonally, so this dropper here is powered by this observer, this dropper by this observer, and so on. Again here, in the a hopper clock, a dropper clock, with in this case 49 items, and if you activate it again, this block here will push down, so this can't read an output. This redstone block can't will be pushed down, so this hopper will give its items into the dropper. important is the amount of items you will need in this hopper here is the amount of sticky pistons you have in your piston extender minus 1. So in my case I have 50 pistons, I subtract 1, I get 49 items. Like this. So let me show you this really quick as well. If it gets activated, this dropper here can read an output, activates the piston, which then pushes down an observer that gives an output to the repeater, which then powers this node block here. 2 ticks delay on with these two observers, powering this this node block here, and then everything just repeats. Then this out from here an output is taken to power this dropper here, so the items will get shot back into the dropper and into the hopper. And then from here there would be just an output taken. So if I just put that to normal speed again, as you can see, oops, items are shot out, and it's done. So if you okay, now I am activating this once, so I will need to take one out. Because this block here needs to be an observer, and it, since they power diagonally, this one here would be the first observer to power this first dropper, not this one. So since now I powered it once already, I had to take out an item, but I will put that in later. So as you can see now, I will just speed this up. Normally this the items flowing into the dropper would happen while this extender is extending. Oops. Now if I activate it again, you can see it's retracting wonderfully. It's not the fast retraction, it's since this is a 4-tick based clock here. 1 tick, 2 ticks, 3 and 4. You could in fact remove one more tick, but I haven't found a working way to put that together with this circuit here then. Okay, and now let's just quickly put the item back in. So it's 49 again. So as you can see here, there are two pistons at the end, which are, when there's a gap, so these aren't fully retracted yet. And for that I made this circuit here. Just need to correct it. So first things first, to find out if you have one or two or three pistons left, since those are the three possibilities that could happen. Easiest way is to find you take your number of pistons, in my case it's 50, and you need to find the next smaller number divided by 3. So in my case it's 48, because 48 divided by 3 equals 16. And 50 minus 48 equals 2. So two pistons will be left, as you can see here. Meaning this will be the first piston you have to power. If you then had, let's say, 33 itself is dividable by 3, so minus 33 equals 0, 0. In this case you will have 3 pistons left, so this one will be the first one that has to be powered. And if you had 31, next smaller number would be 30, so 31 minus 30 equals 1, you would have 1 piston left. That's important because if you were to power the wrong block, for example, one too early, like so, you can see it will break. Same thing when you power one too late, as you can see here, breaks. So only if you, only if you power the correct block, it will actually work. And I'm breaking the ground. Nice. So the way this thing is activated, it takes an output from this piston here. So if this observer can read an output, this gets activated, and an observer right here takes the activation or sees the activation, and then one tick pulses this piston here, which then pulls the slime block with the observer towards itself. And that's why it's important that this in the neutral state would be not attached to the not like this, but rather like this. So if this one activates, or if there are items in this dropper here, it pulls back the observer, and if it's empty, so if all items have been fired into the hopper again, it shoots the observer out again, and normally there would be a concrete block or whatever block I made it, magenta concrete. Oops, now, as you can see, that happens. It fires an output to the front and then activates every single piston. Again, those droppers are all butt powered. And as you can see, the whole design is butt powering. This is butt powering. This is butt powering these pistons. Then this is these observers are butt powering the droppers. And then these observers are butt powering the droppers. So everything is just butt powering. Important: these repeaters have to be on two ticks, not three, not one, not four. Because if I put it on, on three ticks, for example. Can see as you could see it the observer here was able to recognize two changes, so it actually fired twice. And if you put it on one, it will just be too fast, so it won't activate the piston. Then this circuit here is just the activation, so now it would be turned on, as you can see here. Wonderful. And it would just travel to these node blocks here, but you could choose any kind of activation, it doesn't matter. Also, one thing I forgot to mention: neutral state, if the piston is extended, or let's go to the, you can see it here. So here I put everything together. As you can see, neutral state, when this piston is not extended, here the items can flow into the dropper, and on the other side they can't. So here the dropper is locked, the hopper is locked. On this side there, the hopper is unlocked, and if I was to activate it now, you can see this hopper here unlocks, meaning all the items can flow into the dropper, while at the same time this dropper here, the hopper here locks, so every item that gets shot into the hopper stays there. As you can see, it's perfectly fine activating. And if I just deactivate it, you can see all the items, or while this has activated, all the items here have flown to the hopper, or the dropper, sorry. And now, as you can see, everything is retracting, and when this dropper here is empty, you can see this here gets an update, which then gives out an update to the front. And since this is running with the last signal from the observer line here, it will be just perfectly timed every time, no matter how big your piston extender is. And then, when you are staking those together, or putting this side by side. One more important thing is, of course, here you would have to switch between honey and slime blocks. but that's the only thing to think about when you are stacking those sideways. As you can see now, I will just do something here. Well, I hope I could explain everything to you so you were able to understand it. As you can hear here, it's not a quiet system, so oops. Yeah, but works perfectly fine, as you can see. So then, have a nice day. Bye.